All right, we'll skip a little bit here. She's back home. Didn't catch a lot of scenery on the way. It was kind of a hair-raising trip. I don't know why, but this 76, I've pulled 76s before, including Fleetwoods. This one just felt the heaviest of any I've ever pulled, and I don't know why.
I even adjusted it on the trailer to try to center up the weight, and for some reason on my trailer,
you have to keep it what would seem very far back
for a couple of reasons.
Not the least of which
is it'll squash the back of the tow vehicle.
So not really the perfect tow vehicle
to do this kind of stuff, but it's what I have. So, but anyway, yeah, the going through Atlanta might have been part of it, and having a couple of times where the traffic went from 70 to zero in about 600 feet
also made it a little unnerving. But that's just I-85 for you. But anyway, we
not long after picking it up,
and you see how dusty it was, within an hour or so, we ran into one of the famous southern storm cells, and it pretty much pressure washed the dust off this car. We actually stopped
for about 20 or 30 minutes
while it passed over the storm cell, and it was a little unnerving too. It was one of those
where the dark clouds kind of come down low in the sky and you think you see things
turning and twisting. It's like, yeah, let's not do this. But anyway, she's back. Today we're going to try to get it running. The report is that the guy was driving it, he died, and
the sons could not get it started back up. But you know, it occurs to me, we haven't even really done a tour on this car.
So here's the walk around. Interestingly, it's a pretty straight car. Looks like he had one
sort of old man boo-boo here. Other than that, at some point the fillers have been replaced. I think the car's been painted, but it looks like a pretty
good paint job on it. This is the older style fillers that don't have the inside apron. It's just kind of open. And the guy had the vinyl top taken off, which was probably
a good thing,
because everybody who knows these cars knows what happens when the vinyl tops go bad, and especially in that kind of environment where it's so humid and hot, that water will do a number on the metal. And some people, and I've seen a lot of these cars where you could just about put your arm through the side
of the quarter panel here.
This one seems pretty solid. Probably bit of the bubbling here, but overall not bad. So you know, we'll debate on whether or not to replace the vinyl top. It is a D-Elegance, so I didn't
even notice this till the way home.
On a D-Elegance, of course, the top tailors around the back window and runs flush to it. Well, you see this one has rear window trim. Well, this trim comes from a non D-Elegance Fleetwood. So that's kind of interesting. So this should have had the padded top and the D-Elegant script, which was standard. Let's see if it's gonna clear today. This is another weird thing.
This didn't clear
when we loaded it. All the jostling
around, I think it actually livened up the shocks, and it rides higher now.
But as you can see, it's a D-Elegant. It's a clean, I would call it a clean car, but it needs cleaning. It's got a layer of funk on it and whatever. But being a D-Elegance, it should have had that padded top. And of course, it's not just like someone placed seats, you see it on the dash. It's a D-Elegance. And so kind of interesting. But here we have, in the pictures I saw this,
it's some kind of crust.
I don't know what that is. We'll see if that comes off, maybe with some steam. Seats are in pretty darn good shape. You can see we just couldn't stand it. We had to see how that mildew would come off, and it does. There are a couple of burns here and there. Hey, it was a 70s. What do you want? There's a couple of the size of the burns.
Makes me think that it was probably a cigar, not a cigarette.
But who knows? You're not going to find that many non-smoker cars from the 70s. On the other armrest over there at the top, there's a few little, those do look like little cigarette burns. But it's part of the car's history. I think the top, the headliner, well, physically it's in great shape. It's discolored, again, from the nicotine. It might clean up. I couldn't stand it to put a battery in it last night, or battery booster. The little light under here works. The opera lights work. The dash lights and all that.
Didn't try to start it or anything.
But, you know, with these cars, they had a quadrajet.
And they had a type of fuel filter that had a one-way valve. And more than once, I found that that one-way valve is actually just stuck. And so it won't feed fuel. Let's see, the side opens too.
Another odd thing is it has the vinyl floor mats, which may come from a different year, because the 76 had the carpeted floor mats. So I'm not sure what's going on there. There's nothing in the trunk but the spare. I did check that also last night, so nothing going on. There's none, they're not hiding anywhere. But yeah, nice car. Very cool. And a cool color. Maybe I can find the codes to figure out what color top was. It would have been either white or blue, obviously. So again, my dad's. We may do the top. We'll just see, but it's not a priority. Getting it on the road, getting it cleaned up, mechanically sound, which includes new tires, will be top priority. We've already got some nice tires for it. But there she is.
This is the newest tire it's got. It's from 2012.
The others are Goodyear white walls, which have not been made since, I don't know, early 2000s to the 90s. The date codes were different on pre-2000, so I'm thinking they're from the 90s. I haven't found the date codes yet. But this car has a ton of potential, and it's a 76,000 mile car, appropriately being a 76 model. And so we'll get into it, and it's gonna be a lot of fun. Okay, got the air cleaner off, got the mouse droppings, what there were, shaken loose. So we're gonna just see what we're dealing with.
Make sure we have some fire. Whoops.
Give it a shot. Okay. She's gonna run. Well, unfortunately, I didn't have the camera running, but it didn't take much.
Put a little fuel down in the bowl. Put about 5 gallons in the tank, and she fired right up. The guy said it wasn't running. He couldn't figure out why.
But apparently, it was out of gas, so kind of a Billy Bob Thornton thing.
Ain't got no gas in it.
Looks like she's all right. She's running on her own. We're going to get her off the trailer. Just go straight. Just let it roll slowly
under control. You got it.
Keep it straight and you're fine. There it is. So the brakes work. That's a good way to find out. Window works.
Let's start with the basics.
I have a feeling this is just an adjustment. Yeah, you'll have to watch out
for the wheel, because wherever it starts to raise, that's prone to chip away, so you gotta be kind of careful. There it is. I knew there was one spot. You gotta watch that.
What do you do about it? Can you put some sealer?
I don't know what you do about it.
Put some sealer?
We'll have to. If anyone has an idea how to prevent that from getting any worse, that's the seam.
That's the seam. It has to have that.
Yeah, it's not cracked. It's just warped just a little bit in that corner. They're only nice ones. To get a wheel like that redone is about, I think, $1,500.
So So, and there's only one guy in the world that I know of that does it.
You can go to sleep in this car.
Comfortable.
Maybe too much.
Very nice. Well, we'll show the white walls that we're going to be putting on it here. Here are the tires we have. We got four of them. Inch and a half. These are pretty cool. And I'll show you something that's just come out this past year from Vogue, actually. So,
these are Vogue wide white walls.
An inch and a half.
I think they introduced these back in
December.
It's really nice looking,
high quality tires that we shouldn't be dealing with brown white walls on. And a nice looking tread too.
So,
this will really transform this car. Okay, I should have had the video running when I first pulled out, but I'm on the way to the tire place to get those
folks put on. This Fleetwood runs exceptionally well. It starts up with a bump of the key. Just a bump, and she is running. Apparently, all that was wrong with it is that it was out of gas. It runs unusually well. Has auto locks, which is pretty cool. I don't remember that feature on a 76, but drop it into drive and the doors lock. Pretty cool. Odometer works, speedometer works, gas needle works, and it seems to be reflecting only the 5 gallons or so that we put in it. So I'm going over to the place, sans license plate. It does have insurance on it. My dad already put some insurance on it. We're gonna go from there to the DMV, get a plate, and when we're done and we have new tires on it, you know, we're gonna check our fluids and kind of see what it is. It was on the road, I was told, a year and a half ago, so it's not like it's a long-term stored car, so I don't think it'll take much at all to get this one right back where it needs to be. So up ahead's the tire store. We'll talk to you on the other side of that.
There she is.
Shut down for lunch, but we'll come back in a few minutes and I'll pick her up. This is what the doctor ordered.
Yep, she's
off to a good start here. I mean, she starts up on a bump, but you know what comes next.
We're gonna take it and wash it. All she's had is a rain shower wash off so far, but she deserves better.
And I need some lube. Oh, the hinges. Here's something cool. Well, I didn't know they had this on 76s. Drop it into gear. How interesting. So we're gonna take her back to the shop and we'll see what kind of difference these fresh tires make. Everything about this car seems right. Brakes are good and tight, steering's tight, shift's tight, runs great. Someone did us a favor. If you look up underneath it, the catalytic converter is gone. We didn't do it. It's not there, and it runs so nice. Kicking some gravel out from those tires, I believe. Yeah, she's nice and smooth. It's going to be a challenge to keep the this wood grain from chipping. If anyone's got any ideas about how to secure that so it doesn't get any worse, let me know. I'm not sure what you'd do, except maybe put a little resin or something on the edge of it. I'm not even sure. I don't think glue would do much. It's kind of a raised edge just before they start chipping out. That's kind of where it is. The rest of it seems okay. Just that one spot. Maybe a little bit right here as well. Hate to lose that wood grain after all these years. She's riding nice.
Transformation has begun. How's it coming out so far?
Look at that.
This is the fun part. bright white. Any words for your fans?
Fun project. Glad I have the son I do, for several reasons. Fostered my love for these classics. Now I've got one to be proud of. That's what I've dealt with this last month.
Now you get a sense of how it's going to come out. It's taken two washings to get the junk off, but it's good looking. Yeah, kind of the half and half. She's gonna come out good. Some of the blue is a little stubborn on the white wall, but yeah, those Vogue wide whites are nice. My tire guy said these Vogues are actually made by Goodyear. So a good quality tire there.
In case anyone's looking for a nice set of wide whites, I recommend these.
At least as far as the visuals. Kind of covered with some scuzz over here. Got this side cleaned up. Looking pretty nice. That side yet to be done.
This is just simply wheel cleaner.
Wire wheel cleaner. So I'll probably go back with something.
Some kind of wadding like Mother's a little later on. It's dry.
Ace Rothstein in the casino said, is the right way and the wrong way and my way. This is my way. Soft paintbrush on the chrome,
won't hurt anything. A little wheel acid, eat away all this grime.
Two or three times will really do a good job. Okay, so after a long
sweaty day, 48 hours after pulling it out of its cobweb infested crypt,
here she is. 76
Fleetwood Brome d'Elegance, standing proud once more. What a transformation.
That's the quickest and biggest bang for the buck. So we were home within 24 hours of picking her up. And she has been started because she was out of gas. She's been registered by my dad. And we have had these tires put on, which were ordered in advance,
and of course
the day was spent doing a heavy duty wash up on it. But what an amazing transformation. Of course, the obvious thing she needs is her jewelry. The hood ornament is en route. We've procured one, a really nice used one
to go on here, and as soon as it arrives she'll be all the way back
through the first stage, I guess. You know, we didn't get every last thing done.
The bumper needs a good polish, some of the chrome and everything like that. But I talked earlier about the Vogue wheels, or excuse me,
the Vogue tires. Yeah, we were very impressed. Inch and a half, they've got the Vogue emblem, of course, and a really nice looking tread. They cleaned up beautifully. They weren't cheap. But, you know, with these wide white walls, for those of you who have had these, if you try to save money, you're gambling on getting a set that browns, and they do brown. I've had a couple sets that go brown, and I guess you can manage that by cleaning them up. There's a few tricks out there that helps to get them back a little nicer, but this car is deserving of a nicer set. So there they are, beautiful. Didn't really do anything with the interior yet, still dusty and dingy. My dad's going out of town for a week or so, and he's looking forward to getting her back, or getting back and getting her cleaned up on the inside. But just to remind you, I think he did actually clean up the door jams, but that's what it looks like now. Just a little bit dingy. I think this vehicle was smoked in, of course, during the 70s. Most were. Not really badly hurt, but this is the kind of thing that's going to get cleaned up. You got this, let's see. You have this vinyl with kind of a coating of some mildew. It's coming right off. You'll see right there kind of what's to come. It's got the sill plates are really nice. The door panels are nice. I mean, this car is going to be very enjoyable for him. And after we're through with all that, I guess we'll figure out which way we're going to go on the top, whether just to leave it like this for a while or see about getting another vinyl top. I'm going to have to do some research. There was originally that tailored back window, like on the D-Elegance. So there was a couple options. I couldn't imagine going back and not doing the full padded D-Elegance top, if you're gonna do one. But, you know, we'll see. We'll see what's worth doing. But that's the first phase. She's, we may just cruise a little bit tonight and see what it is. We're gonna be making a list of, kind of mechanical
items to look at,
maintenance, deferred maintenance, that kind of stuff, belts, hoses, what have you. But the good news is this is not a long time neglected car. This was on the road. I'm looking and I'm seeing new plug wires and, you know, things like that, and the way it runs and responds,
you can tell this is not something that's been neglected.
It was used pretty respectably. So there we are, and appreciate you sticking with it. Let me know what your thoughts are.
Tell me what you think of these Vogue wide whites. And why not? I mean, I'm glad they got in the game on these things, because if anyone's tried to order the inch and a half wide white walls, they're often just completely out of stock everywhere.
There are just a couple companies left. Of course, you got the Coker Classics.
Everybody knows about those. You've got the Vitour Galaxies, which are a nice looking tire, a nice looking tread. And then the Sure Tracks, all of them, including these Vogues, are 1.5 inch. So
the Coker Classics may be
1 5/8, but all very similar. The prices can vary, but in my experience, the Sure Tracks are pretty good.
The Galaxies, they look great, but they turn brown. And we'll see about these Vogues,
but I don't think we'll have that problem with these.
Anyhow, let me know what you think of that. And when there's more to report, we will report more. I know you wanted to see this. Yeah, we had to do that.
Now it looks right.
Yes, she's complete. What a difference. Even when you're driving down the road and you're seeing that hood ornament. Some cars, they actually
didn't come with a standing hood ornament. But people added them after the fact, and I don't blame them.
Just looks much more prestigious from the inside. So here we are at the end of this stage.
She's looking great. She's running great. The brakes seem to straighten out, but we're not taking that for granted. We're going to
replace the hoses and have a close look at everything.
We want this to be the kind of car that
if Mom and Dad want to go somewhere in, they don't have to worry about anything. So we're going to go through it over a period of time. But she's looking great. We're still up in the air about what to do on the vinyl top. He likes the idea of a blue one. I like a white one myself. We'll probably check the codes, see what color it had originally.
But really can't go wrong either way. I think it probably needs an insert for the back window for that really thick padded top that came on these cars.
Let me know if you've done one of these before. I know on the Bromes, the newer Bromes,
the 90, that style, there was an insert piece that was riveted
and the top wrapped around it to give you that flush look without the trim. So we'll have to figure that out. I guess the other option would be just to put a standard non-padded top, but I couldn't imagine doing that on a car that is actually a D'Elegance. So that sort of closes out this chapter of things. If there's anything new to report, we'll do that. I guess the interior transformation would be the next thing to look at.
Maybe some detailing under the hood,
but we're going
to sign off for now. If you like these videos, like and subscribe. Let me know.
You know,
I've been doing this kind of thing for 30 plus years.
Digging old Cadillacs out of corners of forgotten parts of the world and putting them back on the road.
It's a lot of fun to me.
I'd like to keep that going. Thanks.
This is what it's like to come out of a restaurant and you drove a 76 Fleetwood to the restaurant.
Not much like the others. Tires are doing great. Smooth. It's fun. This car is every bit what it was supposed to be and more.
Dad got a good one.